Welcome back to the Brutal Fucking View, episode 56. I am John.
Ruben.
Connor.
We have special guest Connor here joining us today. Mm-hmm. Connor is actually the person when I told that story about the gun being pointed at us at the Rockingham Mall a few weeks ago. He's the one that was with me. That was the... This is the story, so...
Oh, yeah. Nice.
Yeah. I totally forgot about that.
Did you?
Right now.
Yeah. It's not a big deal getting a gun pointed at you and threatened. Not a big deal.
Now that I live in Worcester, it's kind of like a normal thing.
Right.
It's a normal thing. Yeah. You know? Is it a Saturday if you don't get a gun pulled on you? You know? Is it a good Saturday, at least?
Yeah. You said you're living in the ghetto in Worcester, so it's like a... How is it, I guess?
It's definitely different than like Salem or Derry or any of those.
When did you move out? Was that recent?
I moved there like 2 years ago.
All right.
About 2 years ago. Yeah.
In the ghetto, huh?
Into the ghetto, yeah. My girl already had a place there, so I just moved in with her.
Word.
And then just started doing all that shit.
Yeah.
How was the troop up here today? That's like 30, 40 minutes, right?
That's like an hour and 6 minutes.
No shit, huh?
Yeah.
Jesus. Is it really that long?
Yeah.
Well, we're glad you're here. It took me half an hour to get here today.
Yeah, I was gonna say. Lives in Nashua.
Yeah. So I know how it goes, brother.
Yeah. How is your Nashua place? You still digging it?
Yeah, you know, it's
been like a month or so, right?
Yeah, it's going to be a month, actually, in a couple of days.
Yeah.
It's going great, you know, keeping it nice, upgrading things, buying new
shit.
You
have an apartment?
There. Yeah, I got my own spot.
Nice.
Yeah. A little place.
It's fucking weird with all of us having our own spots and shit.
So we were all old
yeah.
now.
Yeah, like, right. What the fuck? Adulting.
Seriously, like.
Motherfuckers.
But I'm going to buy some plants. I haven't done that yet. I want to buy these little ferns.
Dude, I kept thinking of doing that to put them on that windowsill, but I don't know what I can get that I won't kill. Are ferns easy? Like,
yeah, there are a lot of options. There are options of plants that you can get that are year-round, and you really don't have to pay attention to them. They just live on their own.
And I can just like leave them on a windowsill?
You can just put them out there in the dirt, and they'll be fine. So, yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
You know what's dope, too? You can get a... It's not like really plants, but you can get like live ecosystems. Have you ever heard of people doing that?
I have.
Oh, those are dope. So like the little boxes, right?
You get like a jar and you go to like a swamp and you grab like leaves and wet. It has to be wet outside. So you grab like leaves and grab like a little bit of water and then you just grab a couple of things. You throw it into the jar and let it sit for a few days. And then after a few days, the water, like the murkiness, will just settle. And you can see all the live organisms inside that. Like,
so you're literally creating an ecosystem.
You literally create an ecosystem, yeah.
You've never seen those before?
I've seen them, but I didn't know it was that.
They're cool. They have like little shrimp in them and shit.
Yeah, Jesus.
Yeah. They have like all different types of shit in there.
It's actually really fucking cool.
That's dope as fuck.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I'm surprised. Well, yeah. I guess that wouldn't really be that common of a thing now because it's not like insects are going out anytime soon.
Yeah, me and my girlfriend did it like a couple months ago, but there's really no place in Worcester that I can go grab shit like that.
Right, mm-hmm. Yeah.
Except if I go to this one like pond, but there's a pond in Worcester that kids drowned in like at least once every couple months.
What the fuck?
So there's one place in Worcester, I forget the pond's called, but they say there's a whirlpool. So, like, at the bottom, there's a hole that just sucks everything down.
And you get stuck.
Jesus.
So, if you go to a certain spot and you start going a little deep, you can't come up. So, 3 weeks ago, I think it was, there was three kids on a canoe. They were fishing, and one kid jumped in just to cool off.
And that's it.
The kid got sucked down, and a bunch of kids were yelling for help, and there was a cop on duty that heard it. So, he went and swam out there.
He got stuck, too.
And he got sucked down. They both died.
What?
No.
Yeah. The cop and the kid died?
Cop and the kid died. Yeah, they found the cop faster than the kid because the kid was already being sucked into the ground.
Right. Why does that happen? Why the hell is there a whirlpool at the bottom?
I don't know.
That's cool. Let's figure that out, dude. Let's go out there.
There's actually two in Worcester. One of them, in the last 5 years, like 8 kids have drowned in one of them. And the other one, they say not to go in at all.
Just
but the kids just went for it and they got sucked in.
What?
That's
the
cool
fuck,
as shit, dude.
That's honestly terrifying.
That's what I said to my girlfriend. I was like, I kind of want to go check that shit.
Right.
Yeah. I feel like I'm a good swimmer. I think I could do that. But then at the same time, it's like, I don't know if that's how it works.
Yeah.
It's not. So, like, dude, I know you've had
like
this
pressure
feeling.
Happens, right?
Like, exactly. So, I have the same feeling where I'm like, oh, I'm a pretty good swimmer. So, I put myself in really dumb situations. There's this one time I'm swimming out at the beach and I go way too far.
Sketchy.
That shit sucks you out.
And it sucks you out. And I'm just like, oh, this is fine. Like, no, not a problem. And I'm out. I'm like, all right, time to go back. And
I can't.
It's just not happening. I'm going. Yeah. I'm swimming. I'm not making any headway. I'm out there tired as fuck. Eventually, I just float, and it kind of just brings me around, and I go in. But imagine that force going down.
Right.
You're not getting out of that, dude.
Yeah, but what's cool about Worcester is they do a lot of murals out there. Yeah. So, like, there you – I took a picture of their spray. Did like a spray paint picture of the cop and shit.
Yeah,
his mural, and they put the little boy in the corner.
That's
and shit.
Nice. Yeah,
I mean,
Jesus,
they're still dead.
Oh yeah, they're dead.
They're super dead.
Yeah,
they're for sure dead.
That's a nice gesture. Mm-hmm. I like seeing murals at certain places. When they're good, I should say.
When they're good,
yeah. There's a lot. They just built that Wusok Stadium.
Yeah.
And there, it's popping out there
is
now.
The Palladium open again? Palladium? What is it called?
It's the Palladium. I don't really know if that's open.
Really?
Yeah.
That place was dope as fuck, dude. I've gone to a few different concerts there.
I went there like 3 times. It's the only time I've ever been to Worcester before I moved there was just to go there.
Same. Yeah, same here.
Go to the concert.
Right. There were like battle events when I was going, so I just kept seeing all those. I was like, word. Yeah.
Concerts are great pre-COVID.
Yeah.
But then we know where that went.
Right.
I've been to so many concerts in my life.
What's the most prolific one or your favorite one so far that you've been to?
I went to the Travis Scott one in California.
Travis Scott knows how to perform, bro.
When they did the Astroworld.
What? Yeah. You saw that?
I went to that when I was living there. And it was sick as fuck.
That's wild. Sick
as fuck, dude.
Yeah.
I saw Kendrick live. And when I saw Kendrick live, Travis Scott was a feature. He was a performer on his tour.
Mm-hmm.
And he did a better job than Kendrick.
Yeah.
Killed it, dude.
I met Wiz Khalifa at the Canvas Cup in 2019.
Did you chat him up or just like hey?
No, I didn't really chat him up. When I was living in Sacramento, California at the time. I was literally right across the street, and we bought the VIP tickets. And if you buy VIP, you can like buy stuff and then go in the back and try it out.
Yeah.
And he was like there, but like you must have had like you must have had to be able to get like double VIP to get to where he was.
Yeah,
you could see him, but you couldn't get.
That's
over
it. That's what VIP gets you. You can see him. Like, can I smell him? That's double VIP.
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
And like, can I talk to him? That's triple VIP.
Yeah, I couldn't get that close to him.
No, that's big money. That's big bucks. So, talking about dead kids, would you go to a cemetery?
Jesus Christ. A cemetery?
Yeah, they're a cemetery for like, I don't know, they close off this lake and they made little memorials and now it's like a little kid cemetery. I'd go explore that shit. That sounds like fun.
Oh, yeah. Do you mean just for like the fuck of it?
Yeah,
I don't know.
You can go like ghost hunting.
Get hit.
Would you go ghost hunting? Lit, I would go ghost hunting.
Why not? Yeah.
Now that's the question. You believe in ghosts?
I think there's a logical explanation to everything, so no.
Yeah. He doesn't
believe
it at all.
Oh.
I'm mixed, you know. I don't think ghosts are chilling around with us, but I think spiritual shit happens.
I mean, I definitely believe in something only because I had a buddy named Phil. It was actually his neighbor back in the day.
A lot of stories.
And they always told me stuff happened in the house. And I never really like believed it much. And then one night, like I don't know if it was like a dream or something happened. I used to sleep in the kid's floor when I stepped over his house, and I woke up, or I thought I woke up, and like some woman was standing over me with like his hair and like dress on and stuff. And like, I couldn't move, couldn't do anything. And then all of a sudden, like I snapped out of it, like threw some water in my face, went to bed, and woke up next morning. I told his mom, like, weird dream I had, and she goes, oh, let me show you a picture of the grandma, and it was literally the same hair, same face, same earrings. Ever since then, I actually never slept over his house ever again.
Dude, I would go back and sleep at his house again to be like, okay, let's confirm this shit.
Yeah, you know? I mean, like, that actually unlocked a lot of memories that I completely forgot about sleeping at Phil's house. That's happened to me a few times there, just not that extreme.
We used to sneak out of Phil's house and just go to his house.
Right,
yeah. Hang out with him for a little bit because they're literally like neighbors.
Yeah.
Because his house was fucked. He was just like,
I mean,
it was fucked.
Yeah, Phil's house was definitely a little sketchy.
There was, so the biggest one for me, and this happened so many times, is that his grandmother would always fucking keep the trash lid open.
That's the story I was going to say.
It scared the shit out of me, so we would always close it because it was like a respect thing. Like, just like, you always close the trash can, the trash lid.
Yeah.
And no one ever forgot, and if we did, his dad, rest in peace, would scream at us. He'd like flip shit, be like, close that fucking thing. So there was nights where we would close it. We're just going to bed. Then we wake up in the middle of the night. It's open. We're hearing a woman upstairs. We're like, what the fuck is that? Like, Phil and me are both hearing it. And then we're just like, all right, let's just go keep playing video games. We don't give a shit.
And his grandma's dead?
Yes. Or?
He had both of his grandmas die in that house.
In that house.
Yeah, but I mean, what? Just old ladies are just chilling and opening trash lids. And
I mean,
they're not blowing anybody. They're not cooking in the middle of the night. Not I'm strangling. Not going to wake up with bacon and eggs. Right. Like, fucking useless ass ghosts.
See, that's what my argument is, too. If there's ghosts, why are they always just doing little ass shit?
Why dumb aren't they shit, like, you know?
That's
like,
why,
blow me in the middle of the night.
That's why I always got pissed about watching Ghost Hunters. They'd be like, you hear that? It's talking to us.
Right.
They'd be like, what did it just say? And I'd be like, I'm here for you.
Yeah.
Like, what the fuck?
It's like, why wouldn't you can't
understand what they're saying.
Right. If I feel like if I was a ghost, I'd say the stupidest shit to people. Like, I'd just be like, your shoe's on the opposite foot. Someone's just like, what the fuck? Like, you know what I mean? I'd say something that makes no sense.
I like what he said. Imagine you can't blowjob from a ghost.
Yeah.
Dude, well, all right.
But so maybe that's just what a wet dream is.
So, all right, maybe you're sleeping, is. Right? You're sleeping. Bro, you're sleeping. You're just like, right? And then there's, you're like, oh, this feels good. You're like, oh, shit. In the middle of the night, 3 a.m., you're like, oh, fuck. All right, I'm into this. And you're still sleeping. You don't open your eyes. And then you look down at your blanket, and the blanket's like this. It's like.
It's like moving up and down. Yeah.
It's like this. And you're like, oh, shit, babe, I thought you were sleeping. And you go and you touch, and she's sleeping. And you're just like.
I would honestly look sleeping. Over her, and if it wasn't her, I'd just shut my eyes again.
Yeah.
And you'll be like, let it happen. I'm gonna finish. I'm gonna go back to sleep, bro.
Yeah.
She gonna let it happen?
I don't think it's cheating.
You would let it happen?
If it was a ghost?
Is it cheating?
That's not cheating.
It's right? not a real.
Well, that's not the alive. Question. Yeah, the question is not whether I'm cheating. It's like, what would you do? Would you let her finish? Would you nut? Or would you be like, what's going on under here?
I'd nut.
Like, I definitely nut and then look.
I'd nut, yeah.
What if I stop, or if I did that and then it
stops? And then it stops and there's nothing there and it stops. And you're like, well, you're like, fucking fuck. Come back. Yeah, right? What the fuck, dude?
Then you got blue balls and then you got to deal with that shit.
Right,
you start jerking and your girl's like, what are you doing?
it's a long story. I don't want to explain it right now.
Just there was a ghost. I didn't nut and I'm just finishing myself off. She's like, what the fuck? I'd probably lift up the blanket, look down, be like, what the fuck? There's nobody there. And then be disappointed that my nut is not going to happen.
That is true. I'd probably look first, be pissed that I just got hard for no reason, then jerk off. You know what I mean? I'd be like, oh, I have to fucking do something.
Oh, you jerk off after that.
You're like, oh. Well, if it already started, you know, because you're going to feel something.
And I'd be there like, well, fucking give me a hand. What am I doing here by myself?
Yeah.
You know?
I don't know if I could pull myself to believe in any of it, to be honest.
Okay. Dude, if I get blown in the middle of the night by a ghost, I'm a believer. I'm a believer. That's all it takes. All
right, ghost, you hear that? That's what you got to do.
It's not that hard.
Convince Ruben.
It's not that hard.
You just got to find out where a porn star died and just stay there for the night.
There you go. Wow. You're thinking. That's a good idea.
That's a great idea.
You know, they're just horny.
Holy shit. Right?
Maybe our episode 60 or something.
Let's just find some street thotty until she dies and like just hang out in the area every night.
Just go to Worcester. You'll find... hundreds of them.
Street thotties
everywhere.
That's a race. I was gonna say,
let's just
there.
Get a crackhead from Manch. We'll bring them back here. Let them die here.
I don't want a crackhead blowjob.
How about
a blowjob's a ghost blowjob, like man?
How about meth? There's a lot of meth heads in Worcester.
Yeah,
I call them arm flares
because they flare fucking.
Yeah, they're weird. Yeah. When you guys see a homeless guy on the side of the road and you're at the red light and he's right, you're the first car and he's right there.
Right.
That's one of my favorite things. My favorite thing to do. Usually I'll ask him a question, or usually if I go roll my window down, they'll come up. I'll be like, "Yo, you got a dollar?"
Yeah. No, shut the. You don't do that. I don't believe it, bro.
You got reverse psychology
shut
them.
Shut the fuck up.
Because they're not thinking of that. They're like, they'll they'll just walk away.
Right.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, right. Oh shit, you just asked me for money.
Right.
Yeah.
That's hilarious. That's so fucking funny.
There's no fucking way, bro.
I promise you. Now,
Connor is he's a savage. This
tomorrow
is
morning.
Would consist
no
of.
Shit.
Tomorrow morning when I go to Dunks, I'll send John a snap. You know, I can show you.
So you pull up, you're the first car, there's a guy right there, and you look over and you go, hey. And you start rolling down
he's
the window.
Put his hand out too.
It's like 90 degrees. Right. It's hot as fuck. Right. He has his cardboard sign. He's like, "Oh, I'm getting paid now." He walks over with his cup. He's like, "Hey," you're like, "Yo, yeah, I'm going to Dunks, bro. You got a dollar for a donut?"
Usually, like I usually go inside so I can grab a water or two, and they're just like at least 4 or 5 of them right there.
Jesus.
It's the same people every day.
And you're like, fight for it, bitches.
So it's like, I have before just like looked around. They're all looking at me. I have just placed a dollar on the ground, and it's a fight to the death at that point. You know what I mean?
Dude. Shut the fuck up, dude.
It's fun out there.
They fight over
it's
it?
Yeah,
they I'm fight over it. This is the next episode. We're going to do this shit.
I was going to say, is intriguing now.
Let's go, dude.
You can really do some crazy shit out there if the homeless. If you're bored, you can have fun out there. You know
what I mean? God. Let's start a Facebook group, okay? Let's call it Homeless People in Derry, all right? And then we'll set up a meeting. Like, all the homeless people in Derry have to meet up in this one place.
Okay.
And we'll do just what you said. We'll do it with a $100 bill.
There we go.
Right. Or not
we
a
should
20.
Do it a few separate events, too, so we can have a bunch of people.
A different cities.
Right.
Now, do they have homeless people in Derry?
It's not like much. Yeah. It's mainly in
no, we got homeless people.
I remember, like, when we lived in Salem, like, there wasn't really any, besides that dude that lived at the bungalow.
Yeah, I know, Pat.
Yeah, I think he's definitely dead.
He's definitely dead. Yeah. I can't believe we hung out with
you. Remember how that happened?
At a place where he would buy 10 to 12 year olds and 14 year olds alcohol and shit. It was really fucked up.
Hunter knew him because I guess he was like assistant hockey coach or something with like a hockey. And then he used to go there and he used to be like, yo, buy us cigarettes. We were like 14, 15. He used to go buy us a bunch of cigarettes and shit, buy us like. Steer reserves and like Mad Dogs and shit.
Yeah.
And there was this kid. Do you remember? It was Shay's friend. He was that biker BMX kid.
Vaguely. Yeah, well, anal, but, don't worry. Yeah, so when you have to cut something, yell anal. It's hilarious.
All right, anal, yeah. But it was that kid. He got a pack of cigarettes for us because we didn't have any money. So we bought cigarettes and then he went home, got caught. And he snitched.
On the homeless guy?
On the homeless. Oh, he wasn't homeless at the time. He had an apartment.
This is why he, I think, became homeless.
And then, he lost custody of his kid. He lost his apartment.
Because of that?
Because of that.
Dude, buying underage kids shit is really taken
and
seriously.
Then.
I know, but this is also like 10 years ago.
Yeah. We had a spot in the woods. It was the peninsula. It used to be a road. So we called it the bungalow because we had no place to hang out when we were kids. So we literally found this place and we just claimed it as our own.
Yeah.
And he started living back there.
Yeah.
So like he would even still buy us cigarettes and booze and shit. And then at one point.
He didn't learn his fucking lesson?
Oh, hell no. Yeah. Oh, he used to get drunk with us.
Yeah, I was
going to
say he would get drunk with us.
Like any other drugs or just alcohol?
And like, mainly just alcohol. I think we were young. We were still, like legit like 14, 15, 16 years old.
If we were on drugs, we would probably do it beforehand. We wouldn't bring them to him type of thing. He would just get us booze, stuff like that. So,
And then I think he got like, he started going crazy and shit.
Yeah.
And we had couches back there. He took a couch into the road, lit on fire and started going crazy.
Yeah.
And he got arrested and I never saw him again.
Yeah.
He never showed up. He was never at the bungalow again.
Just gone.
I think he definitely got transferred to either a homeless shelter or a jail.
Or
a
jail.
And then probably died from there.
He probably went to that jail and could never get a ride back. So he's probably in Brentwood still.
Yeah.
Or something. He probably lives in Brentwood, I'm guessing.
They're like, hey, you can get out soon. He just punches a guard. He's like, nah, dude, this is good food. This is a place to sleep. Like,
dude, what a story. Like,
I completely forgot that this even happened. Yeah. So.
There's a lot of old fucking memories that I totally forgot about. There, I'll just pop in my head now.
Yeah, this is another reason why I wanted. Eric said the same thing. He's like, "You guys are probably gonna have mad stories." I was like, "Yeah, dude, with Connor, we're gonna."
I think we started hanging out in like eighth grade or freshman year,
something around there.
Around there,
yeah.
All right, y'all are going fast, so let's slow down.
Hold on.
Like I'm outside looking in. So I had a place like that growing up too.
Okay,
but for me, it was in high school. We used to hang out under this bridge. On these train tracks, and the train tracks were notorious for kids dying on them. Like every year, a boy or a girl would die on them. Like
fall asleep or some shit on them?
No, like just try, like, because on the way home from school, there's one side of Lawrence that you need to hop the train tracks to go over.
Oh, I've been on those train tracks.
So you know,
in Lawrence?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So they're fucking savage.
Yeah.
They're crazy. Yeah. So a lot of kids do it, and there are a lot of safe places to go through, but there are a lot of shortcuts. And I used to take the shortcuts. That's just the way I used to do it. But, like, kids used to die there all the time. But we used to claimed it as our own. And we used to go there and smoke weed and drink, and homeless people too. But so this is a normal-ass guy that bought you guys shit. He was an assistant hockey coach. He had a life. He had a kid. He had an apartment.
Lost
How did you guys know he had an apartment? Have you guys, like, been to it?
Because I remember one day – so my buddy Hunter,
yeah,
he was like, yo, I know some dude that can maybe buy us some cigarettes.
He's and like, you're like, fuck yeah.
He's like, I know where he lives now. He lives like right above the post office that was like 800 feet from that place called the bungalow. Yeah, right. So,
yeah. Which is just a spot in the woods, right?
It was literally like a peninsula in the woods. I bet I could get like a nice little
It's like a, there's like a little like river running to it that or running underneath or next to it that goes into Arlington Lake in Salem. Okay. So it's like on the corner of Arlington Lake.
Is it like swampy or is it kind of nice?
That area is a little swampy, but the way the bungalow was, like you just go into the bushes and then it kind of opened up on the inside. So there was a bunch of land on the inside where you could chill in there. No one could see you from the road, but it was all swampy around it. So
yeah.
Yeah, a lot of people go there just to fish and shit, like regular people.
Is it, but I don't really have that good service, but
so you would just walk on over and be like, "Yo, buy a ciggy."
Right.
We would just yell, "Hey, yo, Pat!"
Yeah.
And if you would hear us, then he'd be like, "What's up?" And be like, "Yo, buy some cigarettes." And be like,
"Was he like a little slow? Or was he like a normal guy?"
He was definitely a little weird.
A little weird, a little slow.
Definitely had. Yeah, I mean,
if you're buying 14-year-olds alcohol and cigarettes, you're a little weird.
Well, yeah, I had this guy buy us alcohol when we were underage too, but he was just thug. He wasn't. Maybe he was weirder than I.
Well, that's like completely underage. That's like,
yeah,
you good.
Were, well, 13, we were young. 14.
We were like 14.
I was gonna say
we had no reason to drink alcohol or buy smoke cigarettes.
Facts.
At that point.
Yeah.
That so he lost. So one of the kids got home, and the parents were like, "Where'd you get these?"
So this kid wasn't really from around here.
Yeah.
He. So all right.
There's just like some kid that got invited out.
So we.
That's some fucking
random. I was gonna say someone who's not out the group.
Oh, like, some fucking random.
Yeah. There were down the street. There's this guy that was a pro BMX rider, and he built bike jumps. And if you went there and got your parents to sign this form, we could all hit the bike jumps. So we used to go there a lot and ride, hit these jumps and stuff. And that kid was a pro BMX rider and or whatever he was. He was just really good. And he used to go there. And then this kid named Shay, he used to bring him to the bungalow sometimes. And that's how all that started.
So he used to hang out with you guys. And he's like, I want to
at the jumps and shit. And then we're like, yo, come back to our little chill spot. Right. He's like, all right, yeah, cool.
Yeah.
So his parents find out he's smoking ciggies and they get the authorities involved.
His mom was definitely a Karen because she went all in, brought the dude to court and shit.
She went hardcore.
Wow. After this one fucking guy.
Yeah.
It's not his fault. It's your fucking kid's fault.
He gave like almost all the cigarettes. He only had like probably like four.
I was going to say, and it was just cigarettes that time too. It was just
like that one time.
Wow. Yeah. In New Hampshire.
That's all it took.
Imagine being that guy's kid like my dad. Fucking dummy ice. He's in Berkshire.
See, like that's crazy though. So I remember like it's a while ago too.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
Remember one time me and John were smoking back in the day and he was like, yo, you should probably put some Visine in. Your eyes are fucking red.
Yeah.
I was like, no, I'm good, dude.
Yeah, fuck it. I was the same way. I'm like, nah, I'm good, bro.
I'm good. Yeah. I'm walking my house and my parents are looking at me like my dad literally goes, holy fuck. I'm like, what's up? He goes, come to the bathroom with me. Yeah. Look in the mirror, my eyes were just like.
You're like, so not only were the red, but you're like.
Yeah.
They're like, who are you just with? I was like, oh, just with John. We were just hanging out. He goes, yeah, hanging out. But like, they never did anything. Like, they never called the cops. Right, they didn't fucking call his parents.
Because smoking like weed, drinking alcohol as a kid, that shit's normal.
Yeah, I was going to say, everyone goes through that. So anal.
My dad's different.
My dad actually. Just retired because 9/11. He went to 9/11 when that happened, and he got cancer from 9/11.
Oh, that's no joke, bro.
Yeah,
yeah.
Fucking real shit.
Lung cancer, or what kind?
He got
I was curious.
Pretty sure it was what the fuck was it? It was lung cancer. It was.
I think that
some fucked up shit.
Lymphoma cancers. That
honestly,
it's not.
It's kind of fucked up. I forget which one it is, but. It was something with the fumes.
I was gonna say
that he breathed in from the plane.
Exactly.
Yeah. Right.
And yeah, he was really bad for a while, but he's good.
He's better now.
He's better now.
No
and
more chemo. He's good. He's out.
No, yeah, he's good. They said that he eventually might come back.
Yeah.
Just because that shit happens.
Right.
That's crazy, bro. Cancer is crazy.
Keep an eye on it, type.
But he retired and he just bought like a $140,000 boat.
Good for him, bro.
Hell yeah.
And
good for him.
He's
bro.
Buying a condo in Florida. So he's going to be out there like most of the
time.
Does
his job pay well, or is that a result of him being hurt on the job? that you gave
He was there for like 30 years. So when he retired, I mean, his pension's amazing.
He's right. Like they took care of him.
And then he also got like figures.
Yeah. Well, there are big payouts for that, for the 9/11 thing.
Yeah.
Like, do you want me to keep any payouts of that? Anyone want me to cut the section out?
Right. Not, yeah, it's not like a big secret, but
yeah.
Obviously, it's not a good thing that that happens, but there are huge payouts for the 9/11 thing.
Yeah. No, that is shitty, though. That sucks that he got it from that. Jesus Christ.
Cancer is no joke, dude. No. Cancer is no joke. And you can get it from anything. It's insane.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
It's always funny. I was always like, I don't really know too many people with cancer. And then it happened. You're like, oh, shit.
Yeah.
And then it's like everybody, you know. Everybody you know knows somebody that has cancer.
I was going to say, dude, my fucking whole family's been riddled with cancer. I know.
Riddled. We're riddled with cancer. That's just funny the way you put
the
it.
Way, yeah.
We're fucking riddled with cancer.
Riddled
dude.
With it. That's
we're
why when I had this shock show, full I was of freaking cancer. Out. I was like, oh my God, I'm going to die.
Whenever you get something like that, you always got to fucking make sure you're good.
Yeah, right. So that's another. I haven't gone to my fucking primary care since I was 18. So then when I noticed this again, because I noticed it a few years ago, and then recently I noticed it, and I was like, Jesus Christ, dude, I have a fucking.
It's like a little ball?
Yeah, it's a lump, and you can push it, and it's squishy and shit. Scare the fucking. Scared me to death.
Let's open that bad boy up, bro.
What'd they say it was?
They said it was a cyst. They said they had no idea what could have caused it, but I've been working out since I was 13, 14. That's usually what it is.
Yeah. So. A lot of those like bumps on you. A lot of people think it's like deathly bad cancer, right. But a lot of it is just cysts.
Dude, honestly, I actually wasn't that upset. Like if it was cancer, I just live my life to the fullest. I wouldn't be that upset about it. It's going online is what made me upset. Doing the research is
that's
what
why,
upset me.
Yeah.
It freaked me the fuck out.
Because you're just like, there's so much.
You never do that
there.
If you have
See,
shit.
That's why my dad was like, I'm just going to go out and buy this massive boat because like I'm trying to have fun.
Yeah.
I'm trying to do my thing. That's and that's awesome, why he, dude. My mom told me the other day, she goes, yeah, we're buying a condo in Florida. They're building it right now.
Yeah. Dude, Jake's fucking like, parents moved to Florida too. Fucking crazy,
dude. How's, that's awesome.
How is Jake doing? I haven't.
Dude, he's good, man.
I haven't seen Jake since we drove back from California.
Really? Oh, no shit.
3-4 years ago.
I was gonna say, yeah, he's doing really good, dude. He's an oil furnace.
I was gonna say, I think I have him on Snapchat. He posted a picture of like when you're in a creepy Manchester basement. That's all he said. And I was just like, oh shit, what's
he doing? Dude, his job is fucked. I guess some dude was fucking working on it in a basement in Manch, and this old vet that had PTSD thought like he let him in the house and everything to work on his oil furnace. And then like after an hour he forgot that he let him in his house and he shot him in the back of the head and killed him. It's fucked up. Like the old vet shot the service tech.
Oh my God. I thought you were talking about Jake. I shot the head. I was like, what the fuck?
No.
I've almost got shot by vets as well. That shit is no fucking joke.
Dude,
bro.
Especially with PTSD, that is scary as fuck.
I don't fuck with vets. I treat them with the utmost respect, bro.
Right.
I'm always like.
Like, I love you, thank you, but whoa.
It's that PTSD that you can't really, you don't want to get too involved
with.
The
Nam ones and the Korean War vets right now, those are the ones that are still going out and they're fucking.
So, like, I'm a salesman, and what I do is I go to house visits. I go to houses and I quote different jobs. I've been doing this kind of jobs for the last 2-3 years.
Yeah.
So, I think it was 2 years ago, I went to this one guy's house, and me and my coworker were knocking on the front door because we're going to, you know, sell this guy some stuff. And he called us out there. So it's not like we're showing up unannounced. He called us. He set the appointment. He knew we were coming. We called him before we were getting there. He doesn't come. So my coworker is like, I'm going to go around the back and see if there's a back door. And I'm just like, let's just hang out here. There's like 4 beware of dogs.
This was in New Hampshire, right?
Oh, this is like in Keene. This is like in Fucktown, New Hampshire.
Kingston?
Keene.
Oh, Keene. Oh.
Farm, New Hampshire.
This is farm, New Hampshire.
Can't, I've always told people, when you're in New Hampshire, you can't go in someone's backyard.
You don't fuck, bro, 100%. You don't go in people's front fucking yard, right, bro.
Seven out of 10 people have guns, carrying guns.
Bro, literally. And they will shoot you because they're dumb sacks of shit. Yeah. That's not a conversation we're having right now. But anyways, so my coworker's like, oh, I'm going to go on the back. I'm like, all right, whatever, do what you do. He was actually like my manager, but he was my coworker, so I'm like, I'm not going to tell you what to do. Do what
right,
you want.
Yeah, dude, right? Go ahead.
So he starts walking around the back, and I'm looking at him, and I don't realize that the guy opened the door in front of me because there's a screen door, and by the time I look over, he has his gun out, and he has it like this, and he started pointing it up towards us.
Jesus Christ.
And he was like, what the fuck are you guys doing walking around my house?
Yeah.
I'm like, my man, we're out here for 5 minutes. Knock on the goddamn door.
Right, yeah.
So,
yeah. And he was white, right?
They always are.
Yeah. So that's the issue, I think, in New Hampshire, is that everyone, most of the older people that own guns are still racist. So it's kind of like, all right, well,
that's why in mass it's not as bad, but right. Still in mass, a lot of people still have guns.
Oh yeah.
But just scratch trail numbers.
Yeah, right. Oh, that's the common thing. Yeah.
It's a huge thing.
It's crazy too, because when I first moved to Worcester, I didn't really think much of it. I hear gunshots like once or twice a day.
Yeah. Right. Oh, bro. It's just like, where, they still do it. They don't give a fuck.
Where I live, like you go like a block or two down, there's gangs out there. Like, I don't know if you guys ever heard Kilby.
Yes.
Kilby's very, very big in Worcester.
Yeah. Violent, or what do they do?
They're probably
really violent gangs anymore.
So they got the younger kids, but then they got the OGs. The younger kids, I mean, they're just
rock kids, shit.
But the OGs, you don't fuck with them.
Yeah. So I might cut this out. I'm not sure, but my
girlfriend had a friend come over, and her man came, and I'm looking at him. I'm like, yo, this kid's definitely gang.
Right. Yeah.
And in my where my neighborhood is Chandler and Oxford, and there's gangs in that shit. But they're not Kilby. They don't like Kilby people.
Yeah.
Like, it's not. Doing being the only white boy in my neighborhood, I do talk to a lot of Spanish dudes out there, and they tell me straight up, like, you can't fuck with these dudes.
Do you know if there's any, like, heavy dominance of a particular culture? So, like, are there a lot of Puerto Ricans, a lot of Dominicans?
It's mainly Puerto Rican, Dominican.
Yeah.
But, like.
That actually brings me back to that. Was your manager white?
Yeah, mega white. Super
and
white.
That guy still pulled the gun out.
Super white, yeah.
Just seeing you guys. And I have a feeling it's because you're Puerto Rican.
Am I allowed to use the bathroom when we're
through? Oh, yeah. No, of course. We should cut because I got to piss after two. So, we'll be right back after these sponsor messages.
You stupid fuck. Are you still wearing Old Navy? You dumb sack of shit. Go to alternativeoriginal.com. What the fuck are you doing?
Hey. Okay. That was it.
I'm wearing fucking.
Is that what you're wearing?
Alternative original, baby. This thing, I feel like I'm in a blanket right now. Like, I feel fucking.
Alternative original, motherfuckers.
Yes. Probably the most comfy winter jacket I've ever worn. Looks comfy. This thing is wild. Got a diesel ass hood.
Straight from a koala bear.
Mm-hmm. And you can, like, tighten the thing so it's like a.
Tighter than a.
Tighter than. Probably gonna have to cut that out. But yeah, it's an ill snowboarding jacket, real ass material. I'm actually starting to sweat just sitting here. I also got the fucking sweats on, but you can't see that in this. But
the
they're also
sweats, kid.
Yeah, so fucking
cool. Look how fly this fucking guy is. Are you kidding me? Are you waking up in the morning, you're putting on your fucking Baby Gap clothes, and you're telling yourself you're not gonna shop at Alternative Original? Look at this fucking guy.
Look
all
at
right?
me.
He's fly as fuck. He's dapper. You want to be
this
that fly?
This is beautiful.
AlternativeOriginal.com, TBV Podcast. That's the promo code.
Again, discount code TBV Podcast. You will get 20% off your entire order. It's urban streetwear. They also sell art, other urban accessories as well, and it's all custom made. Alternative Original Clothing. Back to the episode. Yeah. Didn't you fuck in the closet floor too? Or was that Jake?
That's probably Jake.
Oh, was that Jake?
Jake fucking
okay.
the closet for?
Yeah. Y'all were getting it in, son.
Yeah. I gotta cut this out. She tried to rape me when I was fucked up there.
Oh, well, didn't she?
She did. Yeah. She was our roommate for
I remember that Jake said that. He's like, yo, John got almost like raped.
Yeah. I was like basically blacked out. Like I was laying on the floor and then she just sat on top of me. Laid on me, whispered in my ear, like, fuck me. Like, I want you to fuck me. And she was fucked up too. And Jake was like, yo, he's not even moving. Like, he can't talk. Like, he's not going to fuck
you. Like,
I was like, like on the ground. And then she, like, tried to, like, pull me up and, like, started, like, grabbing my shit. And Jake was like, nah, like, get the fuck off.
That's
and
like,
brought me in my room.
That's like the story you guys told me. You and Jake. And
we can't bring this up either.
No, okay.
I tried to a few times. Yeah.
Yeah.
Cut it out a few times, so whoo, all right, we gotta dive into some topics, man.
Dude, this is wild, dude. You guys have a fucking pass, and I thought my pass is crazy.
Yeah, I told you, dude, our friend group was fucking savage, dude. We had a crazy fucking
wow.
Oh my god, I'm talking about, I mean, it's like Rick's house.
I couldn't even tell any of those stories either. There was too many kids there. Everyone will know what I'm talking about, you know? Because everyone who listens to this is pretty local. Like, we have a few people in West America, some European countries as well, but it's mostly around here, so. Told so far.
All right.
All right, time to get into a topic. 35, 40 minutes in.
Oh, geez.
Okay, so this is something I did want to touch on, just going on a little music tangent. So the past few weeks, so I released a single Friday, and this company hit me up.
2 days ago?
2 days ago.
Yeah.
And he said he wants me to perform live music sessions on like Zoom calls. And I haven't really looked much into it yet, but basically it's just people perform on like some page's IG Live.
Yeah.
And forever how many people tune in for the ticket for the live event, they pay you.
Yeah, really? But how will that – so that doesn't
– basically 20 artists have a 2 to 6 hour event spread out over a few days or a few weekends.
Right.
So they say on each of these days – they're going to have this either Instagram. I don't know if it's Instagram, but it's something like it's a live website where you have to buy a ticket in order to play. And their other artists on it have like a lot of fans. So a lot of people tune in, I guess. I don't know. But
would you perform your stuff live? Are you down?
I don't think I would, because I'd be rapping into my laptop screen. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah,
it's hella weird.
It wouldn't be. And you wouldn't even have time to edit it.
I feel like middle of COVID would have been dope.
And what are you going to be like, high on pills, on Zion Hill, exactly. Like in a Zoom call?
Exactly.
You know?
So with the beat playing, it's like, I don't think that would sound good. Yeah. I don't think that would look good. Mm-hmm. I don't think I would even tune into that if another artist did. Yeah. You know what I mean?
I'd watch that for free, let alone pay for that.
Yeah. But apparently, so I looked it up because I thought it was like, what is this bullshit company? It's called Sessions Live. And apparently the guy that founded Pandora made it.
Oh, shit.
So it's like a legit thing. So I was like,
yeah, get in early.
I don't know. Maybe it's something I could consider, but I feel like I'd want to do a live show. I wouldn't want to do a
pre-record a live show and then just air it.
Well, no, I mean like a live show in person. Like I wouldn't want to do like a live fucking laptop show.
Would you do a live show? Like actually in person there?
No, I tried to Eric's like, fuck, I just woke up.
You can come still. Does he live far?
30 minutes.
I was going to say, he lives in Salem. He lives actually by where Anthony lives.
Tell him to come by. I can stay till like 1.
No, I was going to say, I could tell him.
I haven't seen him in fucking 5 years.
Been a minute.
I haven't actually come to Salem a lot lately. It's because my dad had the cancer and everything. Like,
yeah.
Really no reason for me to drive. That's the thing. I live an hour away from Salem. So it's like drive an hour. Hang off a little bit and then drive an hour back. It's just a waste of gas.
Right.
To a point, you know what I mean?
Right.
So it's like, I don't really come out here too much. And I work 6 days a week, so it's...
Oh, yeah. Really? So we're Saturdays too? I know that, bro.
Yeah.
You know 50,
60 hours, so it's like, it's hard
that
to...
Game, bro, believe
that's
me.
Basically what Eric's been doing. That's like why he hasn't been on the pod the past few weeks.
He does like heavy equipment stuff?
Yeah. No, he's still working heavy. But we've talked about this a few times on the pod. I won't keep it into it. Basically, what I was going to say was the last time that I've done this music shit, so like 2 or 3 years ago, I only had like fucking 3 songs out. I tried doing a show in Manchester. It's extremely fucking hard to do hip-hop shows in New Hampshire.
Right.
So that's why it's so difficult. I have to go to Worcester or anywhere over there. I have to go that far in order to actually do a show.
Worcester, Springfield's like very underground.
Exactly.
Stuff.
So I want to try doing them again this year. Now that it's like post-COVID. I don't know, but so you saw fucking Jordan Lucas in Worcester.
Yeah, he literally, it was yesterday at like 1 o'clock.
Yeah. He sent me a Snapchat. He's like, dude, I just saw Jordan Lucas.
I tried getting him on Snap.
Like,
I tried whipping it out fast enough, but as soon as he saw me taking out my phone, he fucking sped off.
Well, I mean, that makes sense, right, dude. If you're a rich guy and you're just trying to stoplight, somebody says your name and he's trying to grab you on photo, you're like, man, I'm trying to just pick my boogers out here, you know?
Especially with his reputation in Worcester.
He's not really liked in Worcester, actually, at all.
Yeah.
He reps streets that he's not from, and people find that disrespectful.
Yeah.
Who gives a fuck?
I don't know, man. It depends
It's the OGs that don't like that shit.
I was going to say.
Man, these OG bullshit, man. I hate it, bro. I think it's so fucking dumb.
That's me too. I'm moving out of Worcester at the end of the year. I'm buying a double wide trailer.
Where at?
In Clinton, Mass.
Bro, you know what, dude? That right there, where you just said, a lot of people will disparage that and be like, man, you're going to live in a trailer.
Fuck that.
You own the land. You own the fucking property.
Facts.
It's low investment.
Yeah.
It can depreciate. Yeah, but the cost of living is going to be so much lower than what I'm paying.
So much.
You know, it's crazy. People do look down that, but where I think where I'll say them is a double wide trailer, brand new, is like nice. Is like $60,000, right?
Right.
It's big.
And you put like $15,000 down, and you take a loan out. You're paying, I don't know, like $500 a month on that, and then to be on that park, the rent there is only like $200 a month.
Right. Yep. Yeah.
Exactly.
Dude, and I was gonna do that same thing, but
me and my girlfriend, we want to build the house.
Yeah, so that's basically why I stopped, because I got some money, so I was waiting.
Yeah, but right now the lumber and shit, it's just so expensive. Crazy. They say if you were to build the house right now, in 5 years, it'll lose like $250,000.
Right.
Which is exactly why I'm not buying a house right now.
Yeah.
It's just not point.
So I'm trying to get a duplex. So I have a pretty hefty down payment that I got recently that I'm trying to put into a house.
Would you find a duplex? I have a duplex. I know of someone. But it's in Clinton, Mass.
I was going to say, I'm sticking to New Hampshire.
Stick to New Hampshire.
I'm not going to Mass.
No.
Mass sucks.
I can't live here.
New Hampshire's the only way to... It's impossible to live in Mass.
Yeah.
It's the third most expensive rent in the entire country, in Massachusetts.
Taxachusetts is still the good name for it. It's been like that for 20 years. People used to call it Taxachusetts, and it still holds up to this day.
Dude, you pay crazy taxes. The cost of living is through the roof. Everything is $1 million. It's like, I love Mass, don't get me wrong, but my God, it's impossible to live here.
It's
impossible.
I never saw myself living in Mass.
Yeah.
I was a Mass guy all the way through and through. I was a Mass hole. I never wanted to live in New Hampshire.
Born a Mass hole. Yeah. I fucking grew up a Mass hole, but just couldn't. I don't know.
What kind of watch is that?
This?
Yeah.
Citizen.
That thing is dope. I'm just trying to build my credit as high as I can get it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So that will be in like next week or 2 weeks from now.
Yeah. Nice. No, that'll be dope.
I've been just trying to build credit as much as I can.
You have a car loan?
No.
Do you have a credit card?
Huge help.
I have a credit card, yes.
Nice. Okay. Keep paying that.
Keep paying that.
What I do is I'll spend like $60, $70 in gas every month on the credit card.
Yeah. No, I do the same exact thing.
Slowly build it.
Yeah.
I bought my car in cash for like – and I took a little loan out.
Yeah.
Paid in cash mainly.
And it's under your name and everything, because that's still
– I have it all under my name. Yeah. So. I bought it.
No, if you pay cash, it doesn't build credit.
No, it does if you have a loan. If you pay the loans on time.
Oh, yeah. If you pay the – yes. Yeah. The only way you build credit is if you – it's a hard credit pull and it's a loan. Right. Exactly.
Yeah. So we did from like the couch that we have, the TV.
Best Buy. Like go buy a fucking computer. No interest.
Get it and then slowly pay it off.
Yeah.
Or like this advice that I heard online is, dude, get a bunch of no interest cards from like clothes stores or what did we say earlier? Fucking – anything. Doesn't matter.
Low that can get you, though. That can mess you over in the long run, though.
You got to pay attention to those things.
Yeah, if you forget about
it. The one I got for my bed was around $1,000 with the mattress, bed frame. It was a whole set and everything.
Yeah.
So I opened a card with Wells Fargo, but they said if you don't pay this off within the first 6 months, it doubles in interest every single
Fargo?
Month. So it goes 12%, 24%, 36%.
That shit's fucking joke.
I don't know if you ever want to ever do a brand, but they fucking suck.
Oh, yeah. No, I've learned from them. This was like 3 years ago. So
they're the worst.
You miss a payment, they'll charge you like $75.
Right. But I got all my payments and did it within that 6 months, shot my credit up, and then I deactivated the card. So I did it correctly. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I didn't use it anymore after that. I didn't take anything else out in my name. So can't build any interest.
Another really good thing to do is pick a bank that you like and stick with that bank and open a debit, two credit cards if you can. You know,
I just have my bank with where my job goes through.
What is it?
Webster 5. They don't really have any.
They're just decent.
They're just a smaller bank, but the best bank is honestly DCU.
I was going to say DCU. I have had them for years.
Because they give you good interest rates.
Amazing interest rates. Yeah. I'm refinancing my car for 1.7%.
Yeah.
Insane, dude. That's like unheard of. That's
good. I don't know if the listeners are going to gravitate towards this credit talk.
Yeah. Let's move away from
it. Off of it.
Let's veer
off.
Did
I have something else with music? Yeah, there was a fucking dumbass conversation that went on Twitter. Usher said in an article like 3 or 4 years ago, and then someone randomly blew it up, but basically T-Pain ruined music with auto-tune. Do you guys agree or disagree?
No, 100% disagree. That makes no sense. It's a stupid-ass statement. It's ridiculous.
He does use a lot of auto-tune, though.
He didn't ruin music, though.
So he didn't ruin music.
Yeah.
Now, question here. If we're talking about music, do you think like Biggie, Tupac, and them led the way for hip-hop? Because there's a lot of – I was watching the the Mike Tyson, he has a podcast.
Yeah.
And I was watching his podcast.
His podcast is dope.
He was saying that because of like Biggie and Tupac, hip hop is the way it is now.
Yeah.
But he's not wrong in saying that because of them going as hard as they did, we have trap now.
Right.
No. We have certain kinds of rap now.
The beef, the good content, the different coasts, everything about Biggie and Tupac literally paved the way, in my opinion. Mm-hmm. I think it still would be rap today. I just don't think it would be aggressive.
It wouldn't. Yeah, maybe not as aggressive as it is right now.
Yeah.
But everybody has a different influence. My personal favorite is A Tribe Called Quest because they changed it up. Because they went from like just hard gangbanging rap to all of a sudden storytelling.
Right.
Jazzy rap.
Yeah.
And you're just like, whoa, where did this come from? So I love that. Because without A Tribe Called Quest, we wouldn't have J. Cole. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I think that statement's true with Biggie and
J. Cole plays basketball?
Yeah.
Dude, he already quit. He's already done.
Nasty at basketball, though. He got injured. Good.
He's done.
Yeah, no, I think he's like almost 42, right? He's like, yeah, I think I gave it a good run, but I'm not going to.
He was on the Rwanda basketball team.
What?
Yeah.
I didn't know they had a basketball team.
Oh, the Rwanda African League, yes.
Yeah.
There's
At first, I thought you said like Wakanda. I was like, shit, Wakanda.
No, Wakanda's not real.
I was going to say, Rwanda. I wish it was. I didn't think they had the infrastructure for a basketball team. That place is fucked, dude.
I mean, there's always the good and the bad, but I don't know too much about Rwanda to defend it.
It's like ran by like a guerrilla militia group, basically.
But he was on the Rwanda basketball league.
Yeah.
You know, the basketball team in the league. I think it was like a national league or something.
Yeah,
like that.
Right. They like pulled from everywhere.
I love the state of rap today. I love the state of music today.
I do too, dude. I think music is amazing right now.
Right now, it's in an amazing place because there are so many different branches of it.
Yeah.
You know what
There's
I mean?
A lot of different exploded. Stuff you listen to nowadays.
Yeah.
You can't go, oh, I don't like rap anymore because like, oh, what kind of rap don't you like? You don't like the hard stuff? Great. Listen to jazzy rap. You don't like the jazzy stuff? Great.
I'm not gonna lie, I'm not a big fan of the mainstream rap at the moment. And by like mainstream, what? I kind of mean like DaBaby. I'm not the biggest fan of him.
Oh, yeah, the
even like the Migos, like I like their music, but I won't download it.
I put it, you don't listen to Migos anymore.
Yeah.
They're just too like
I got over it.
Yeah.
I got over it.
It gets old.
I got over
it. It's weird. I'll listen to a song for like 2 weeks straight and then I'll just stop listening to it.
Yeah, because you burn it out and then once you listen to it again, you're like, ugh, I'm done with this shit. Yeah.
I like to have a good rotation for that reason, so I don't listen to the one song too many times. I just always keep a good 200-300.
And like that moment when you find a great song and that's the only thing you listen to for like 2 or 3 days.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But no, I think music is in a great spot. All kinds of music. And Tyler, the Creator, just dropped a new album.
Yeah, he did.
It's really good.
I've listened to one song and I was not into it.
Dude,
really?
Not into it.
It goes back to Cherry Bomb. Like, he has old sound.
I don't like any of Tyler's new shit, so.
Yeah.
We grew up on Goblins and shit, and then we stopped.
Oh, my God.
You went back to that.
Yeah.
Yeah, but the song I listened to, it was just deep.
The album's all over the place. You have to listen to certain songs.
Right.
No, what song that popped up on the I have this music app. I forget what it's called. I think it's just called Music. It's just like a free downloading music app.
And yeah.
That song Worldwide Choppers came on the other day.
Really?
Tech9? I was just like, oh my God.
That was crazy.
He's so good still.
I haven't heard that in a minute, dude.
I don't know if he still raps, but he probably still does.
Dropped two albums this year, dude.
Really?
He has like 40 albums. That is like the biggest, most independent artist of all time.
Yeah.
Who?
Tech9.
Strange
music makes no sense, dude. I don't know how the fuck that guy has so much music in his 40s and he's fucking Jesus.
Yeah.
He literally has over 30.
You know what I think's funny? Like, when MGK and Eminem had did that rap battle, ever since Eminem made that song about him, when's the last time you heard a song from MGK?
Oh, well you know
it's
what?
Not rap anymore.
He doesn't do rap anymore. He does rock, right?
I switched to rock.
Yeah. I see why.
Yeah.
Well, dude, no, MGK, after this whole Eminem beef, he kind of blew up.
He did. It helped him.
It was publicity. Hard.
It gave him huge publicity because both raps weren't bad. I'll give MGK credit.
No, he did good.
Still think he had the better song, but if we're talking about diss tracks, Eminem annihilated him in every possible way.
Like, yeah, there's no 100%. Way, but the song itself
but
was
the
fire.
Song was better.
You can listen
was catchier,
to the song
you know
and it's
what
like,
I mean?
Yeah, it's good.
Yeah, now that he's dating Megan Fox, he's blown up even more.
Yeah, okay.
he's a beast, man. I'm a big fan of like changing yourself, of doing new shit. So I like what he's doing. You know, I'm not a huge MGK fan in general, but I like the fact that he's branching out and trying new things. I think that's awesome. That's
I think he's good.
I think it's cool.
I don't know.
You think Kanye is going to drop something good? Yeah. Or do you think he's all done?
Now that he's split.
Kanye is fucking crazy.
Do you think he's done? He had no more good music?
You know, something on the radio the other day, they said that he went to a strip club and paid a stripper $25,000 to listen for 4.5 hours. Just talk.
I saw that too. That. Yeah. That's something Kanye would do, though. That fits him.
But that's therapy. He just paid.
He just wanted to just have someone therapy. To talk to.
Yeah. You know? I mean, he could have paid a therapist less and actually got good information. I mean,
probably, that takes actual planning. With a strip club, you just show up.
Exactly.
He probably still fucked her, but.
Right?
Maybe. He's a fucking.
For $25,000, I mean.
I was reading an article that he used to watch the Ray J video and Kim Kardashian video on repeat, like often. Yeah. He used to watch it like every
night. No, I've never watched that video.
It's special.
Dude, it's fucking stupid.
It's not good porn.
It's not even a good, exactly.
It's not a good porn. Yeah. She doesn't move or say anything.
You barely see her.
She's like, sexy, so, don't get me wrong, but it's
just, I can't say too much about this because it'll ruin like a lot of things, but I have been
ruin my life.
it would ruin a lot of things that I'm doing, but me and my girlfriend stopped. But I was streaming for a while and I was making like really good money streaming.
Like gaming what? Streaming?
Jerking off.
Yeah. Is it kind of OnlyFans? Kind of.
It was, I mean, it's not like gaming streaming, but like mainly like me going on and like just, it's kind of like talking. It's kind of like podcast, but not really podcast.
Yeah.
You know, it's podcast. You know?
Okay.
And honestly, we were making, I was making like a couple hundred dollars every time I went on. But I stopped because someone messaged me and they were like, you can like record people and stuff.
Okay.
And they're like, uh-oh. I know who you are.
Uh-oh.
And since then I just stopped because it's like,
yeah,
I wouldn't want certain things to branch out and slowly
affect
the rest of my life. Yeah.
Was that on Twitch? What was that on? It was just recently.
That was recent. I mean, I have a full streaming setup too. Like, I have the mics, we have light setups, a bunch of different camera gear.
Okay, I'm confused though. So you played a video game, but it was just more of you talking while playing the video game.
Yeah, it was more.
I can cut it out if you.
How do I say it? Like, yeah, you might have to cut this part out.
Okay. All right. Okay.
Or no, you were doing.
Doing it.
Oh. Doing it.
Okay, cool.
Mainly like you don't really do much. You just talk about things. And like I would just have my shirt off and then maybe.
But that sells, dude.
It sells. Just
big time.
Just the talking part of it.
Yeah.
Fucking huge. Because
you got like a lot of people that during COVID and stuff have money. They don't, like, all the people, they don't have the fuck to spend it on.
Right.
So, like, they, like, would just sit there, and it's more of the conversation, like, you talking to them back and forth. Like, they'll, like, message you, and you could just talk to them.
Yeah.
But every time they message you, it pays you.
They have to pay to send you a
message. They got paid to send you a message.
I've seen this. Yeah.
Man, we were getting, like.
So you were camming, bro. You were camming.
Yeah.
A couple thousand people.
Yeah. Oh, shit. That's nice. Yeah. I'll chop that up to make it, you know. So that's dope. Would you consider doing that again?
It goes right to my house fund.
Yeah.
That's what all we do for us.
Fucking.
Yeah. Make money from my house.
Might as well. Dude, you know I actually.
Don't hold back. Go for it, bro.
I'll say this is unrelated, so it doesn't sound aggressive. I, with my ex, we were trying to set up a couple's porn thing on Pornhub. And we were just weren't going to show our faces or anything. So it was just going to be our bodies.
A lot of people do that.
And my dick and her everything.
If you go on Pornhub right now and you click a video, another thing pops up. And most likely that's the website I'm on.
Yeah.
It was like the cam free stuff. The what is it called? Now you got me curious.
Yeah, adult free cam. There's a bunch of like stuff that
you're going to have to cut this.
That's a big one.
I am gonna have to chop all that up because I don't want to put that shit in with my ex either.
Chop a little bit up, but Yeah, I mean, it's,
that's kind of cool.
That is dope. Pretty dope. I was gonna say that is kind of cool.
That is kind of cool. Yeah.
Yeah, we have every like month it takes it out. Yeah.
Okay.
You can cut okay. states out.
Yeah.
I cut New England out fully.
Right.
Okay. So no one from New England could see me.
Right.
Just people good in call. Other parts of the United States.
Yeah.
Other parts of the country.
Someone's like,
which isn't a big deal. Like,
I know who you are. That must have been sketchy. Yeah. Once they said that,
we stopped for a little bit.
Yeah.
But why'd you get so scared? Why not just be like, you know what? What's the worst that can happen?
Yeah. I mean, I don't know. That's a big privacy thing for me.
Yeah, but what's the worst? Like, your privacy is people see you, you know,
basically,
slightly undressed.
Basically, my opinion, the worst is someone records the screen. They screen right. grab the whole session. They okay. post it on Facebook.
All they would have Twitter. To do... All they would have to do is just screenshot it and send it to my boss.
Yeah, exactly.
And see that, like that we're just talking... Talking on like a porn site, and
yeah,
probably get kicked from that.
Right.
So, do you have a job that's sensitive to that? That's why you're like worried about it. What kind of job do you have?
I mean, it's not. It wouldn't be that bad, but they definitely give me shit.
Right.
Yeah, but dude, this is your own personal free time. What you do in your free time is up to you. They can't, unless if you're being insensitive, like. Even if you're doing actual porno out there, I don't think your job can even say anything.
No, they 100% can.
Yeah. Well, what? Like,
if you show your face, you can get taken off of anything publicly, especially from occupation. So any job has the right. If you show your face and you're completely nude, they can fire you just from that. If they show your face and you're grabbing a girl's boob, they can fire you. Even if it's playful, even
it's
if
mainly
it's
mainly
crazy.
It's mainly
any job can do it.
That doesn't make sense.
It's mainly too, like all the jobs we do, if like if I were to go to a job and I do the paperwork and I talk to them, if they were to like notice me,
yeah,
be like, I've seen you before.
Right? Yeah, because then they'd be like, oh, are you going looking at couples just sit and talk in their clothes? And yeah, that's where you saw me. I mean, I guess this is difficult for me because if it were me in your shoes, I would be like, I don't give a fuck.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I
mean, a lot of
like,
employers wouldn't give a shit.
You
know what I mean? Like, a lot of them would be like, yeah, good for you. Have
it's
fun.
It's right, mainly exactly. just because it's a porn site.
Yeah.
I feel you. I feel you. Know? You.
But that's the way I was like, I don't want to do it on Twitch because everyone does Twitch. Like, I need to find some old horny dudes that are willing to pay to ask questions about our life. I mean,
Sex sells, dude.
Yeah, it any does. It really does.
Any type of it.
I was hoping you would say Twitch, and I'm like, damn, I'm gonna set a Twitch today. I got all that shit.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Yeah. You can make a fuck ton of money off Twitch, dude.
Dude, I got a webcam. I think I want to buy one of those just curtains to put behind me. I want to start streaming, man, because I already play.
Streaming's fun.
It's fun.
Yeah.
And all my friends are like, dude, you have the person that all you do is talk when you like play video games, so just do it.
Yeah.
So
I think you play video games enough too. Like my issue has always been I don't play them enough, and I play them in quick spurts. So
I play
it wouldn't be any.
I play it every day. Like that's my thing. I
so
love
then
to play.
You
it's
definitely
my shit.
Do it.
It's
then.
My shit. You know?
I
might have to use restroom.
I was thinking that too. I kind of have to piss again too.
All right, let's take another break.
All right, we'll pause again. We'll be back.
Cool.
Now with Hydrocell, staying hydrated doesn't have to break your bank. A 64-ounce bottle like this, under $30. Use our link in the description. Get yourself one today. Stay hydrated, you goddamn fool. Get yourself a 420 cleaner today. Under $20. Please, all your pieces. Acrylic, glass, doesn't matter. Use our link in the description. You fool.
This episode is brought to you by Amazon Music. Amazon Music is one of the best exclusive music apps out right now. I actually use that because I have an Android, so I don't have Apple Music or anything, and the YouTube Music is kind of it's hit or miss sometimes. Not all the music's on there. Google Play is kind of hit or miss too, but Amazon Music has everything. You use the code BROOT and you can get 3 months free now instead of just one. So if you go to getamazonmusic.com/BROOT, BROOT, you can get 3 months free of Amazon Music. Again, that's getamazonmusic.com/BROOT. Get 3 months free. Back to the episode.
Like that girl, Bad baby. Bad baby. The girl that said,
bro,
catch me outside. She made $1 million in one day.
I was going to say, wasn't it the first day?
$1 million in one day.
Bro.
That's money.
Those girls out there that are grinding, showing their shit, and making that money, good for you, dude.
I mean, I'm not going to say a last name, but it's like, I mean, A lot of people watch this from around here.
Let's actually have some content. Yeah. Let's.
Big debate. AC, having AC on in the car while you're driving and having the windows down at the same time. Does it waste the AC? Does it matter?
It waste gas.
My opinion, it doesn't matter.
It doesn't fucking matter.
It doesn't waste enough gas.
It's a great feeling if you can let go of, you know, being stingy and you can have the AC on a full blast and the windows on a nice hot day, sunny. It's the greatest feeling in the world.
I agree.
Because you get the wind.
So you're on the it waste gas side. You're on that side.
Yeah, well, I mean, I waste gas no matter what.
Yeah.
I'm on the if it feels good, just do it.
Yeah. I have in my Jeep, it's like a limited edition. It's got a cooling seats, so if you're wearing things, you can it cools your balls down.
I've heard of heating seats. Cooling seats is fucking
All it does is blow air.
Cold air on your ass and your balls and your back. And honestly, it stops from your back sweating, which is nice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, that's nice as hell. It's like an air bidet. That's pretty dope.
It's like an air bidet. Yeah, something like that.
That's fire. I didn't know those existed.
I don't care about being wasteful, dude. Just fucking do what you want.
I was going to say, I don't think it's enough where people will actually debate it. And it's a big debate online. I was like, are you serious? Like, apparently people are like, yeah, it's a huge fucking
just
waste.
Just do
like,
it. It's awesome.
I was like, yo, it's not using that much gas if you do it. Might, but it's not that much.
Going to get my AC, AC fixed tonight. Oh, I'm bringing my car to the dealership tonight, and they're gonna have it for a few days.
Guys drive your car with the AC? Like, do you guys throw on the AC when you're driving?
I never use it.
I was gonna say, ever. I think I use it when I'm driving home from work because I go to work in like a suit and shit. You know what I mean? Oh. So I'm sweating dick when I leave work and it's 90 degrees out. Tomorrow it's gonna be 95 or 97 or some shit.
I live 0.4 miles from my job, so just by the time my AC really kicks on, I'm already home.
You're there, right? So it doesn't matter.
Yeah,
there,
I don't use AC at all. I usually, even on the highway, I put my windows down all the way.
It feels better. Yeah.
It feels way better, and you can blast your music really loud. You know what I mean? Yeah. So I kind of like that.
All right, I'm gonna spice this fucking shit up. Connor, would you fuck a retarded girl?
Oh my god,
is she blind?
She's just retarded. If you want her to be, she could be blind if you want her to be.
I have to be drunk.
So you would?
So you're at a party. There's this chick, and she's a little slow. You know, you try to have a conversation with her and she just doesn't get anything you're talking about. And you're like, but she got titties done.
Well, not anymore since I'm in a relationship. I wouldn't do that.
Yes, of course. This is a hypothetical.
Hypothetically,
hypothetical. Yes.
This was three years ago.
It has to be like, back in the day when I was like 19.
Right.
She's hot.
She's hot, but she's retarded.
She's just not there.
Yeah. You know, she has the full.
It's like a butterface.
You know?
No, she's like that?
Yes.
So you talk to her and she goes,
yeah.
I can't do that.
Can't do that. Okay.
That's fucked up, though.
So there's a line on the spectrum you will fuck, but once it crosses that.
Jesus Christ.
Asperger's, that's fine.
Okay. I would too. Yeah.
But
you can't really tell Asperger's. They're just weird. Yeah. A lot of weird people probably have Asperger's that don't know it.
Right.
You know?
Gonna say we could potentially have Asperger's and not know it.
I don't think so.
Maybe I'm not gonna have my girlfriend watch this.
No, this isn't a great idea. No.
No, it's all hypothetical. All
right, so if she's like, no.
That's definitely a no.
That's a no for me.
Ruben?
Oh, hell no.
Okay, all right.
Absolutely.
I thought you were gonna be like, yeah, but okay.
No.
I wouldn't either.
Well, dude, I mean, I've talked about this. I'm not huge into hookups. I think hookups kind
of
suck.
Yeah, you're more of a relationship dude.
And it's also going to suck if she's fucking retarded. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And that's not a rag on her or females or retarded people.
Yeah.
That's just a combination that I'm all set with.
Yep.
I'm good.
All right, another wild hypothetical. Let's go. You're hottest girl you've ever seen. You're 18 years old. You're at the beach. She wants you to eat her out. You go down, worst thing you've ever smelt in your entire life.
Oh, do
you
keep going? That.
You know you're going to get pussy at.
Wow. I've been in that situation. What's your answer, bro?
Do I have nose plugs?
No.
You could plug your nose with your
but
hand.
But you want it, bro. Like you're in, bro, and you're just like, this pussy smells like fish market.
Like bad.
At Sunday on a hot day at 3 p.m.
We're at the beach. Yeah, are we in the fucking bench, like right on the beach walk, boardwalk? Are we like
no? It's I'd say it's you can be inconspicuous.
You're under the pier.
Yeah,
in the sand.
So it smells worse.
So as sweaty as hot.
Yeah.
So at that point, you wouldn't really notice the smell of her, be sure.
Oh, because you're thinking it's okay. I like your thinking. You gotta, like, think I like outside your the thinking.
Like, so you're like, yo, this pier smells like shit, dog. And you go, and you come up like, it still smells like shit.
Yeah, right.
So you go.
It depends. I have a pretty. I'll gag. If it's that bad.
I have I gagged. I have gagged.
While eating someone out?
Continue. Don't fucking ask me questions. That's him questions.
But dog, oh, come on. That's a good point. You've gagged before?
Yeah, bro.
Dude, how offended was she?
She didn't say anything.
You know it hurt her so
much. It hurt her, but she didn't
say
anything.
She'd probably be a little, I feel like if you were to gag, she'd be like, oh my God, it smells. But she won't say anything.
You go down and you go, what the fuck are you supposed to do? Like, it's involuntary. And I still ate her out. I still went for it.
All right, I'll flip this. What about, how about if you know you got the stankest balls in the world and some girl's trying to blow you right now, you can't get to a shower or anything, but she will do it right now.
She wants to blow me. She can let her? Yeah.
I can't, dude.
I care about her, yeah. If I care about her,
even if it's a random girl, I can't do it.
If it's a random, I'll be like, yeah, suck.
Oh, if it's random, it's random.
Yeah, but, yeah, exactly. So even if you've been working out all day, you've been working all day, and then at night she's finally like, oh, I want to blow you right now.
You worked all day. You worked out when never, you got home. You went to the beach after the gym. You haven't showered.
Haven't showered.
Right. You got straight up cheese, dog.
I feel like I've done it before.
Yeah, bro.
There we go, baby. Right. I love it. That's
and
a real answer, bro.
You would do that if it was a random.
Yeah, who gives a fuck?
I couldn't do it.
I'd tell her. I'd be like, yo, I got cheese. And she's like, I like American. I'm like, it's more like Swiss.
What if she was more like, I'm more of a Swiss American. It's not my type.
Yeah.
I'd be like, I got provolone. And she's like, I like provolone.
Oh, yeah. Okay, how about this? What you if you care about her? But then she's like, no, don't shower. I want all the funk.
If that's what she wants, and that's what she wants, what am I going to do?
I don't think
bro?
I do that then.
I don't think I could do it, dude.
Bro, if that's what she wants, give it to her. Who gives a fuck, dude?
I guess it depends
on how
much
I like
her. If she
wants a cheesy dick, then give her the cheesy dick. Dude, I saw this video once.
Oh,
so fucked up. I saw this video where this guy had actual dick cheese.
Yeah, I've seen videos like that. It's so gross. Yeah. Yeah.
That was real, bro.
I couldn't fucking do it.
Bro, he had a foreskin, and she pulled the foreskin.
Have you ever seen Breakfast of Champions?
No. What is that?
I don't really want to explain it.
I don't think
is
we should explain
is
it.
Is it like a dirty sexual thing?
Yeah.
This comes out Wednesday mornings. We're going to make people throw up if
look,
we explain it.
Look, just one day when you're alone,
bored.
Hold on,
look, tell me.
We can say it off air. We can say it right after.
Can't you say it on air?
Okay,
fuck
and then we'll cut it out.
Why are you going to cut it out? Fuck it.
It's pretty gruesome. We're an hour in. Like, I don't know. How many girls watch this? But if a girl's watching this, she will cut out.
None. That's fine. Go for it.
We do have a few female listeners. Yeah.
Maybe they won't cut out. Maybe they'll be intrigued.
Yeah.
But they have to be like real fucking.
Real freaks.
Dude, you got me going. What is Breakfast of Champions?
Real freaks. I don't even know if I should. Maybe I should just show you a picture.
To my knowledge, it is basically.
I'll show you a picture of it.
All the funk put together. Out of the butthole.
Nope. That's not even it.
That's Breakfast of Champions, to my knowledge, right?
Dirty buttholes?
No, it's like you shit.
Yeah.
You got shit in the bun. No, he's shaking his head, so it's something different than.
It's not that. I don't even. They may have taken it down.
You know the old cookie?
It's
the cookie nut thing,
it's
too?
It's super bad to the point. I think I could only find it on like thatsfuck.com.
That's where we used
to
find it.
Yeah. Okay, so let's stop right there because that's.
Yeah.
Just describe it to me. What is it? Is it one video? Or is it like a series?
It's one video. It's probably about like 3 minutes long.
Oh, fuck. You guys remember when you saw for the first time those fucked up videos?
Like yeah.
The one
girls,
hammer video.
One hammer.
The one man, one jar. Two girls, one cup.
Doing the girl.
Okay, that's
one man,
let me
one
just
horse.
Say it's kind of like two girls, one cup.
Right.
Oh, okay.
So that's what I thought. Where it was, I thought someone like they did a prolapsed asshole or something, and then they ate like food off of it.
No.
Cereal.
Good.
Cereal. Is that what I'm thinking?
Out of the prolapsed anus, because I've seen
and
them.
You
before.
Literally put milk and shit in it too, and you scoop it out.
No.
I think we are gonna cut.
All right,
this
I'm
out.
Done. I'm gagging.
Wednesday morning.
No, don't cut it out. Leave it in. Bro.
I don't know.
People love that gross shit.
I don't think they do.
I can't
bro, look
even
at why
find
I
it online. So they must have somehow taken it down.
No, yeah, yeah, dude. You have to go deep into the dark web to find
all right,
that
I'm
shit.
I'm good. I don't
want to
see it. I don't want to see it. That's fucked up. that kind of shit is savage, bro. It's not Reddit. YMH Live, which is Your Mom's House Studio Live by Tom Segura, Christian Pizzuzzi. They go hard with a prolapsed anus.
Gross.
I've seen way too many prolapsed buttholes.
Yeah.
And I have a picture of it if you want to see it.
You should just look at it just once. Yeah. Just once. Just once.
Oh my God.
Bro.
He's like, I gotta look. Tell me that isn't terrifying.
It's 3 minutes long.
I remember watching it. There's milk.
The spoons included.
Yeah.
Is it just one guy eating this shit?
It's two girls.
Two girls.
Girls are sad.
Girls are fucking, dude. I think girls are more kinky than guys when it comes to shit like that.
Dude,
like,
that shit's crazy. Son.
Yeah,
that shit's crazy.
They don't even have the video.
For this, I'll go is fucking thumb on the butthole.
Yeah,
you know what I mean.
Yeah, yeah. No, I'll do shit to a girl's anus, but I probably can't.
Girls' butthole. Or yeah, butthole. I'm confused
there. Huh? No, buttholes are great.
A little bit of both.
my little brother, he's they're 15 and 16, and I think he was just goofing around, but he goes, "Isaac, yo. You eat ass?" I'm like, "Fuck yeah, I eat ass." They're like, "No, you don't." I'm like, "Yeah, I eat ass. I love that shit." They go, "What the fuck? That's crazy." Because like they all the kids talk about it, but they don't really
know. I actually got,
I'm like, that shit's awesome.
I got yelled at by a cop. They harassed me because I had a sticker on the back of my car that says, "I eat ass."
Who gives a fuck?
And they harassed me about it.
Did they really? They like said shit to you?
They pulled me over and they're like, "You need to take a sticker off your car."
Did you do them. It? No, right?
No, I didn't.
Yeah.
Did you argue with them?
But it was a magnet. Someone snagged it off my car.
Oh, yeah. Well, I probably would have snagged it, too, if I saw that shit. I'd be like, word. Cool.
That, I hate cops.
Yeah.
I hate cops so
that
much.
Is fucking stupid. Freedom of speech. Suck my dick.
Suck my balls. Like, they have too much power. They
could
have
said so much worse.
They have way too much power,
I think
power,
if
dude.
You don't eat ass, you're just not, like, open to try new things. I mean, if you don't eat a girl's ass, it's
straight
just,
up. That's like,
do you really love her? Yeah, like, I love my girlfriend, I'll eat her ass.
Straight up, bro.
Off the bat.
I'm not going to lie.
If you say you love a girl, eat her ass.
Right, yeah.
Straight up, bro.
I'd do anything sexually if I was in love with a girl, I will not have them touch my asshole. My asshole is completely off limits.
All right, so
we've talked about this.
You're
before
with a girl with your dream, but she wants to peg you. I think I've already asked you this before. You're not
doing
it.
No. She couldn't even stick a finger in it. She couldn't even.
Let me tell you, if it's with the girl that like I'm really into, this girl, I'll do almost anything.
Yeah.
Except I'm not into the whole wife swap and threesome.
Yeah, right.
I get too jealous, to be honest. Yeah. I wouldn't be into that. Like cucking? Yeah. Like, no, I'm good.
Yep, no.
I'd be a bull, but I wouldn't cuck. I'm all set.
There was a hilarious conspiracy theory called the ginger side going around Twitter's trending things. Literally called ginger side, like genocide or homicide. The theory is that all the redheads in old Disney movies and cartoon shows are being replaced by black people. They're saying it's black Hollywood taking over gingers. And I was like, you guys have a lot of fucking free time and a lot of bullshit if that's what you're complaining about.
Yeah, I don't even, I'm you know not what I mean? Say anything about this.
That's fucking hilarious. That's we're supposed to make jokes about it.
That's ridiculous.
So I
you got too much time.
I do know that TV show Paw Patrol, they took the cop dog out because they said that the dog shouldn't have more power than other people.
Oh, I did see that, yeah.
But you know what, though? And I...
All right, well, so we'll wrap up with a little rapid-fire questions.
True.
This is the same continuation of last week. I don't think we've gone through all of them, so...
Nope.
All right, Connor, basically these are just would you rather. Mm-hmm. We like to call them gun to your head, so gun to your head, do this or this type of thing.
Mm-hmm.
But the point is, answer them as fast as you can without thinking. First thing that comes to
your
mind.
What type of guns, though? It's like if it's like a 22.
Jake has the exact same
if it's a 22.
It's a 50 caliber.
Okay.
Yeah.
You're dying
you're
on
dead
spot.
No matter what. You're dead.
Okay. That makes sense.
All right. Would you rather.
Who are you asking?
Connor. Okay. We're going to do three questions. Answer them as fast as you can.
And then we're going to take turns. We're going to go around.
And then he asks you, or he asks me, you mm-hmm. ask him, stuff like mm-hmm. that. So, all right. Find a dead body or to be a witness to a deadly assault. That's a good one.
I'd probably rather find a dead body.
Okay.
Only be able to wash your hair twice a year or only be able to check your phone once a day?
Check your phone once a day.
Yeah, what the hell is twice a year? That's a weird
answer. Unless you want dreads.
Eat a live worm or be locked in a room with a tarantula for an hour?
Eat a worm. Remember that?
Yeah.
Fifth grade? Phil ate a worm?
Yeah, I do remember that. Yeah. That was mad funny shit that we... Remember we used to snort like tadpoles and shit at Hunter's house? I don't know if you were there.
What the fuck?
Yeah, it was weird. So those were three.
Cannot do that. Dude, you guys are snorting live tadpoles?
We did a lot of shit.
Yeah, dude, one time...
You just... Bro, yeah. What the fuck? That's just swimming around your lungs.
Rest in peace to Williams, dude. He would take a tadpole. The thing was still squirming around. He goes, shoots up his nose, and then goes, and it came out on his tongue.
Still alive?
Yeah, still alive, and he just spit it out back in the water. All right, what was the other one you did? Wash your hair twice a year. Yeah, why the fuck is that a question? That's stupid as hell.
Unless you want dreads.
Only be able to wash your hair twice
a year. I would do that one because I have a beard.
You can't wash your hair with dreads.
Oh, I guess that's true because you're bald, right?
Yeah. So. And then I don't wash my beard. I don't even want to say daily, not even at all because of the oils. I'll break out.
Yeah, you can't wash your beard too much with the oils now. Yeah. You'll get
fucking I only go with water and I like take the shit out and that's it. But I don't do soap. I do a face soap, but not on my beard.
I was going to say, I do face wash on my beard. Should I be doing that?
No, not at all.
You should not be doing that.
Yeah, so what you want to do is I put my face wash up to here and then I stop.
I do that with the actual face like cleaner, but yeah. I use the soap where it's like body and face wash, yeah, I put that on and then after a few times, I was like, I feel like my hairs are dying. Like,
I use my girlfriend's hair stuff. Yeah. I use my girlfriend has.
Really?
It's like this like fucking, it's like not like rocky, but it's like, like little clumps of it, and you just wipe it on, and like opens your pores up.
Yeah, that stuff's not good for your skin.
No, it's not.
It's not good for your skin.
Well, it is if you like have a wicked bad breakout. You're trying to clean something, but I wouldn't actively.
Well, it's not good for your face.
Right, right.
If you have back knee, that's awesome for your back knee. But your face is so sensitive that you shouldn't be doing the rock stuff.
I had number four at the bottom where I just had it folded.
You ready? Yep. You ready? All right. Be able to change the future or the past just by imagining it.
Future.
Have thought bubbles appear over your head for everyone to see or for everyone you know have access to your search history.
Everyone I know to have access to my search history.
Same here. I don't have crazy stuff.
I think everyone knows I'm watching porn. Like, than what I actually search. So.
Seriously. Like, you're watching porn? Like, yeah, bro. I'm watching a guy eat a girl's ass. I like that shit. What do you want?
Everyone's got that in their history. So
right.
Everyone has that shit. Get off my case. Facts. Moving on. Anyway, yeah, right?
We all agreed on that one pretty consistently.
We all like, not a big deal. Yeah, so, straight up. I'm glad we all agreed there. And be 4 years old for your entire life or be 90 years old for your entire life.
That's horrible. I guess 90, because at least I'll be able to talk.
No, I'd be four, bro. Then,
four? You can't do anything.
At 90, you cannot do anything.
What can you do at four that you can't do at 90?
I run.
No, you can't.
Swim.
In some scenarios, you can't.
You both shit your pants.
You both shit your pants. You're both stumbling. You can walk a little bit. You can run a little bit.
Bro, but you're still going to live a long life. You're just going to have the body of a four-year-old. You're just going to be a little human.
But you stay four, though.
You stay
at that same age.
No.
I took it the same way.
I don't see it that way. I see it as living like you're Benjamin Button. Like you live your life and you're just 4 years old.
So you're like, say you have a 30-year-old mind and a four-year-old. You can
still get buns. I'm still getting pussy.
Yeah, that's the scenario.
Your dick's mad tiny at that point your whole life.
Bro, and you think if you're 90, you're going to get a hard dick at all?
You can have pills.
Your dick's still...
You gotta got a wrinkly dick.
It's
going
to be bigger soft than a four-year-old.
Bro, the girls you're pulling at 90 are not the girls you're pulling at four, bro. I feel you could pull some serious...
What if you're Hugh Hef?
Huh?
R.I.P. What if you're Hugh Hef?
I don't know. What was
Hugh
that?
Hefner, the Playboy Mansion guy?
Oh, yeah.
90 years old, had fucking 12 bitches around him on a daily.
Yeah, but dude, you think he was...
Not at all. I don't even think he was having sex, to be honest.
No, dude.
Yeah.
You know
he
what I mean?
He saw that shit so much, he was probably desensitized to it.
At that point, he didn't give a fuck, bro.
I'm still going 90, dude. I'm going 90.
No, I'm going 4.
You're going 92?
I'm going 4.
I'll probably be...
You're on number 7.
Yeah. So ask Ruben from number 7 to number 10 at the bottom.
7, 8, 9.
Okay. Save 3 of your closest family members or 1,000 people you don't know.
Ooh.
From death? Yes. Oh, closest family members. Easy. That's not even a debate.
It's a good one.
Fuck the people I don't know.
I'm with you there.
Have a lot of metalcore friends or only one really good friend?
Have a lot of what friends? Metalcore?
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 I don't know what that means.
Can I see that?
I don't know what that means either.
Am I saying that wrong?
Mediocre.
Oh my gosh.
Have a lot of mediocre. I'm like, medical. Mediocre friends or what?
Or one really good friend.
One really good friend.
Yeah, that's a weird question.
Easy. Yeah, that's the situation I have right now.
This one's a little messed up. I'm not going to lie.
Hit it.
Smack a puppy or get smacked by your dad in public.
Ooh, that is kind of fucked up.
Oh.
Now,
I'm gonna smack a puppy.
Yeah, dog poops in your house. You gotta smack it.
You gotta, a puppy, I don't like though? Hitting dog. I don't. A I will puppy? Never hit a dog normally, but I'll smack.
I'm thinking
puppy.
Of a little fucking. I don't know, man. Oh, golden slapped retriever, by your dad in public.
Fuck. Yeah, my dad's never hit me before, and I don't want it to start there.
My dad's so. has hit me in public. Would be weird because my dad would be no. He'd be straight faced the whole time. So.
Yeah, I agree with let 1,000 people that you don't know.
I would too.
Who cares about 1,000 people that
three close family mm-hmm. members? Like, they should have worded that. Like, maybe if it was three people you know and 1,000 random people,
because,
but like
what,
family
my mom,
members,
my dad, and my girlfriend,
exactly.
I'm not gonna let them die.
What the fuck?
Yeah, for 1,000
for any situation,
people.
For 100,000.
That was the last one that page.
Mm-hmm. All right, mm-hmm. We can wrap up. We've been going for about 2 hours. We fucking
let's wrap it up.
Well, I should say an hour 40. Mm-hmm. I don't have any other fucking funny things. Everything else is just dumb. So anyone else? You guys good?
Nah, man. It's a beautiful summer. Remember to go out there and get some sun. Wear some sunscreen. Wear
what
sunscreen.
Day is it? It's the 30th, I think. These drop Wednesday morning, so.
It's 27th.
Wednesday morning.
Oh, drops. I was like, dude, yeah. A couple days off.
It is not the 30th.
You're like, I don't think you're... okay. Happy Wednesday morning. I hope this... episode took you on a journey. This was a wild episode. We mm-hmm. went serious, then funny, then stories, then
a lot of fucked up shit.
Weird fucked
a lot
up
of
shit.
Fucked up shit.
Yeah, this is gonna be an interesting listen. Thank you, Connor, for coming through.
No problem.
And if there's one takeaway from today's episode is if you love her, eat her ass.
Yeah.
Definitely eat her ass.
Definitely eat her. If you really love her, eat her ass.
Yeah.
And that's all I gotta say.
That's, I think, what settles it. You don't actually love someone until you eat
until
their
you
ass.
Eat their ass.
That shows love.
Thanks for listening. We'll be back next week. Peace out.